Alright, another day. I had lunch at home today. My mom made me a home-cooked meal, something that I don't get to have often. I'm going to be alone at the shop today, so I'm going to get to do... I feel like all those meetings, the kind of work that we get done during like meetings and stuff, I don't feel is very productive. Even though I know it is, it just doesn't feel that way. And so when I go in there and do paperwork and, you know, like package boxes and ship stuff out and assemble product and come up with new product, all that stuff, I feel like it's more productive. It's just, I think the difference is the payoff is a lot quicker. And so that's why it feels more productive. But, you know, the meeting things, those are gonna pay off. So the kind of work that I can do today, I feel like it's gonna be more productive and I'm gonna feel better at the end of the day, which is good for my sanity. So today I'm here by myself because Misa is shooting with Greg Benson. If you don't know Greg Benson, go check out his channel right here. Greg Benson, it's a big time YouTuber, which brings up the topic that one of the negative commenters on the channel was saying. He said that I am pretending to be a big shot YouTuber, you know, I'm pretending to be something that I'm not, which I think was a little bit wrong because I... So, pretending to be someone you're not, that's like a kind of a trick thing, because there is some truth to that. I am pretending to be who I want to be. Like, if you want to be successful, you gotta convince yourself first. Like, the external stuff, it's secondary to that. And so if you want to be successful, if you pretend to be successful, then eventually you combine that with hard work, you are going to be successful, right? So whatever you want to be, you gotta pretend, you gotta convince yourself, you tell yourself, you give yourself pep talks. Those are scientifically proven to work. If you are having a bad day and you force yourself to smile, science has proven that does have an effect in your state of mind. And so there is some truth to that, but the larger truth is that we are among big shot YouTubers. You know, like I said, my brother Misa today is shooting with Greg Benson. This guy's got a few million subscribers. We shot a bunch of stuff. I'm gonna put a little video when we went.
This is YouTube Space.
Get your ticket, right?
Let's try to get it.
Space is very interesting. So we just saw Michael from Vsauce, but he kind of just got away from us. We'll try again later. Which, it's a pretty cool place because there we got to shoot with another big shot YouTuber, Anna Akana. And she was, you know, she's got over a million subscribers also. Now she's in the movies. The other day we went to see Ant-Man and it was completely disorienting to be watching this movie and all of a sudden her face is on camera and we're like, what the hell? Like, I know this girl. Why? So, anyways, I am not a big time YouTuber. But I will be one day, and I'm surrounded by them. We're working with them all the time. And so, yeah, thank you for calling me that. Now, let's get some work done. So it's a good thing to try to be positive every day, as much as you can. Oh my God, what is going on here? But it is a challenge. Today I posted a video of a guy hitting a dog. He's like a mailman somewhere. I don't know if it's in the US. It looks like it might be some other country. But there's a little dog there that is barking at him. And when he comes close to him, he takes out a baton and just whacks him in the head. The dog goes you know, like, he clearly is hurt. And it's a tiny little dog, by the way. And the guy just delivers a mail and then takes off, you know. And so it's really infuriating to see people be cruel to animals. I don't believe in violence per se, but those people need to be stopped. You know, when someone is hurting others, there needs to be a mechanism to stop them. And so I don't really know why I share those, because it's obviously not a positive thing, but I have seen positive things come out of the collective outrage. There was a guy recently that had tape shut a dog's mouth very, very cruelly, and the dog was gonna suffer, you know. The dog escaped, and it hit national news, and it was all over the place. And within days, that guy was caught and was prosecuted and was put in jail. Is that a good thing? I don't know. You know, it's like, is that going to prevent that guy from ever hurting another animal? I mean, while he is in prison, he won't be able to hurt another animal. And so that, I think that's the reason why sometimes from time to time I share those stories. Some of them are really gruesome. And so, you know, I have dogs, and ever since I got my two dogs, I think that my point of view has changed. I didn't always used to feel this strongly about this topic. And so I struggle to, you know, remain positive every day. That is the quickest thing to derail me on a daily basis. If one of those stories or pictures or something comes up in my feed, then I kind of lose it, you know what I mean? And it comes up because I like animals, and I like stories about animals being cute, being, you know, themselves, and being awesome. Animals are awesome. And I think they deserve our protection, because we are basically their biggest threat. We are endangering their habitats, or endangering their planet. There's no other species that is aware of their own damage and is not doing enough about it. We are the only ones. And so I think I've done enough work here today. I'm gonna go and spend some time with my dogs.
Next week at the same time.
Rock and roll. No, what is that? No, I don't like that.